Once upon a time, in a strange but wonderful land, there lived a little girl. This little girl was loved by all in her village, but none loved her more than her granny. The girl was known as Little Red because of her vibrant red cape her grandmother had made for her. Sadly, Little Red's granny was ailing, and this brought great sorrow to the girl who loved her granny dearly. So one day, Little Red set across the forest to where Granny lived. Little Red set out on her long journey, slowly at first, because she loved playing in the forest. A while later, Little Red began to feel she was not alone. She began to peer into the deepest, darkest patches of the wood. She called out, "Hello, is anybody there?"
"Hello, Little Red. That's an awfully nice cape you have on there."
Little Red in her youth was not yet wise to some of life's unsavory characters and didn't know to be wary of the wolf. And so she stayed and chatted with the beast. "Thank you, Mr. Wolf."
"And where are you going this evening, little one?"
"To Granny's house."
"And where does Granny live?"
"Oh, quite a bit from here, in a little cottage." Now, this poor wolf lived in a forest where meals were few and far between, for things had happened in this place that made things not as they should be. The wolf had not been given an opportunity to feed himself in a while, and thought this might be his chance to not have one, but two juicy treats.
"Say, Little Red, look around you. I fear you move so fast you cannot appreciate the beauty of these woods. Take a moment. Look at all the beautiful flowers that grow. Would a bunch not cheer your granny?"
"You're right. She would be very happy with these exotic blossoms."
"Hello, Granny."
Little Red began to feel uneasy and quickened her pace to Granny's. Before long, she gets to Granny's. "Oh, Granny, won't you please come to the door?"
"Oh, Granny, what great ears you have." "All the better to hear you with, my dear."
And what great eyes you have."
"All the better to see you with."
"And what great hands you have."
"All the better to touch you with, my child."
"And what great teeth you have."
"All the better to eat you with."